tall. Good evening. It's finally a nice night for a concert. The last three I've done has either been snowing, raining, hailing, or something of that nature. So glad that we have a nice evening here for you. And hopefully you enjoy tonight the Jazz Ensemble 1, Jazz Ensemble 2, and the return of Jazz Ensemble 3, which is really kind of cool, right? This band, we had some saxophones and some trombones and a couple trumpets, and I'm like, you know what? I'm just gonna put this out there and see if anyone else wants to play in Jazz 3. I thought maybe I'd get three or four kids to show up. I didn't know I'd get 300 or 400. but that's okay. This band is for maybe some students who've never played jazz or did used to and wanted to come back to it. We have some students in here that are in Jazz 1, but they're playing a different instrument in Jazz 3, and they're doing really well. Something like that, I think I already said, you know, people who've never played in a jazz band before that wanted to, didn't want the pressure of an audition, or whatever. So hopefully we can keep this alive. We used to have 4 jazz bands. Last year we only had 2, so hopefully this is a good sign to come. But now we have 3, maybe next year we'll get 4. So without further ado, we're gonna get started. We're gonna start with a great old standard that I first became familiar with from the When Harry Met Sally soundtrack, sung by Harry Connick Jr. We don't have Harry Connick Jr. or anyone like him here to sing tonight, but we're gonna, Avery, you wanna sing? Okay, all right. So this is It Had to Be You. Ryan Cordero there on the piano, right? You'll see Ryan a little later on playing a different instrument for sure. Yeah, I'm really impressed with this group, man, especially, you know, the limited amount of rehearsal time we have with them. We really only go once a week for about an hour, and the problem sometimes is we run into, like, you know, musicals rehearsing, and then they have their tech week, and we can't really be in there, and but man, these guys, sometimes we rehearse on Wednesdays, sometimes it's on Mondays. It's when we can get the space to rehearse. So really, really proud of this band and how they sound, right? They're doing great. They're doing great. So I tell you, a few thank yous we'll do now before we continue. Certainly like to thank our Board of Education for sure. Very supportive of us, our central administration as well. Dr. Freeze, Dr. Shula especially, our superintendents. The NAI administration, because we have NAI and NASH kids involved here. The NASH administration, my supervisors, Natasha, TJ, and Art, are fabulous to work for, extremely supportive, and I'm just not saying that. I don't even know if they're here tonight yet or not, but that they don't need to be. They're awesome people to work for. So give them all a round of applause for the administration. And I know I say this, Mr. Baldanzi says this all the time, we really would be nothing without the NADVP and parent volunteers. You guys do so much that goes unnoticed, and you do a lot that goes noticed, but I don't think people understand, you know, the amount of things that go on. So thank you to all the parents, and especially our Band Booster president this year, Amy Bistokis. So Amy, I see you. Stand up. Oh, come on, Amy. Thank you, Amy. Thank you to all the parents. Really, really appreciate your support of the kids up here and the arts, and it really is a wonderful thing. So we're going to continue on with a tune I'm sure you know, written by the great Henry Mancini, Pittsburgher, right? This is entitled The Pink Panther. And what jazz band doesn't play that, right? Either that or Peter Gunn. We're not going to do Peter Gunn. We'll do The Pink Panther. Thank you. Yeah, nice job. Nice job. Good job by our drummer too, Sean Morgan back there. Good work. And our bass player, Chris Reynolds. Yeah. Okay. All right, so one more thank you here we want to do is, I don't think he's here tonight, but I want to thank Bob Tozier, our music department chairman, who does a ton for the music department and the school in general. So really, really, he runs lights and sound and all that kind of stuff. He does so much more of the stage up at Nash. But tonight I want to thank Evan Brown, who's back there running our sound system back there. Evan, thank you, man. Thank you. And also tonight we have Braden Turner, who kind of pulls double duty. He's playing tonight, but he's also hitting the record and running the ads. So give it up. All right, so I hope I get this right. This is going to be our last tune, and then we're going to do Bring Jazz 2 up. This tune is going to feature Matty White Wolf on the alto sax, Ryan Cordero on the piano, Grace Yook on the flute, Alejandro Rode on the barry sax, and Dan Longo on the guitar. Yeah, so basically what I did is I said, who wants the solo, right? And these are the kids who wanted the solo. So I said, all right, we'll do it, right? I don't quite understand this tune very much. I guess they do. It's from a video game or something called Undertale. I know Pac-Man and Space Invaders. Donkey Kong, maybe, yeah. So, yeah, this is Toby Fox's Megalovania, whatever that means. Okay.
All right.
big band in Chicago this weekend, if you want to check them out. All right, thank you. Give us just a moment. We got to downsize the stage here a little bit for Jazz Ensemble 2. Thank you so much.
All right, how's everybody doing? Yeah, all right. So this is Jazz Ensemble 2, and we're gonna go and do a little Buddy Rich for you. And the first tune is called Big Swing Face. It's gonna feature Blake Alfer on tenor, and Braden Albert on the trumpet, and then Amisha on the drums. So here is Buddy Rich's Big Swing Face. Thank you. All right, our next tune is a Stanley Turrentine tune called Minor Chant. It's going to feature our soloist Beck Thompson. You're going to hear a lot of her tonight because she's my senior, so I put her through torture to make her play all these solos. And then Andrew on the trumpet over there, and then Jeffrey Kern on the piano, and Anthony McDonald. I skipped a tune. Blake, again, on the tenor sax, and then David on the trombone, David Williams trombone. So here is Minor Chant by Stanley Turrentine.
Thank you.
All right, one of my favorite contemporary jazz pianists is Mr. Chick Corea. He just passed away recently. But one, he wrote many great tunes. One of my favorite tunes is called Spain. And he had his group with Stanley, Santa Clark, Return Forever, a great group. So he wrote this tune called Early Afternoon Blues. It's gonna feature, once again, my senior Beck. David again on the trombone, Jeffrey on the piano, and then we're here, our barry sax player, Mr. Anthony McDonald. So here is Early Afternoon Blues by Chick Corea.
Thank you.
Jeffrey, I just noticed your socks. You got little piano keys on your socks. They're so cute. Yeah. I want piano socks. Yeah. All right, we're going to do an original. What is this? Kind of a funk? No, it's more of a shuffle, right? You're doing a shuffle beat on this, David, right? So this is a little shuffle called Bad Dog by Mike Dana. It's going to feature David again and Anthony, and they're going to do a little trading fours and trading twos in this solo section. So here's our version of Bad Dog.
Thank you.
awesome feature of our bass player, Mr. Reynolds, laying down that funky line. Very good. Awesome. Bad Dog. We're gonna slow things down, and it's another original, but it's in style of Count Basie, so it's a really cool tune. It's gonna feature back again on the alto sax. Here is Cruisin' on Crush You. Thank you. All right, we got one more for you. But before we do that, I do have one senior I want to recognize. Actually, I taught the whole family, didn't I? Except for that string player over there, right? Please. Oh, my God. But Beck, yeah, so 4 years. And did you do all 4 years of jazz? No. Well, we had that little thing that stopped the world, right? So that kind of screwed things up a little bit for us for a while. But now I think we're back on track. So you're going to Oberlin next year? And where are you going to major?
Geoscience,
whatever that is, that's kind of weird. Give it up for that. So, Oberlin's a beautiful campus. I don't know if you've ever been out there, but my brother-in-law actually went there for school, and they have an amazing music department. I hope you get involved with there, and they have great parties, but I don't remember those, but they told me they were good. Okay. So we're going to do one more for you, and it's called by Herbie Hancock, and it's called The Watermelon Man. It's going to feature Peck one more time, and Blake on the tenor sax. So this is Jazz Ensemble 2.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, we're gonna get rolling here. The Jazz Ensemble 1, here we go. tune was named after something the band had for dinner tonight. Fried buzzard. No. Actually, there's a whole big story that goes with that tune. It was actually originally written by a man named Lou Donaldson back in 1965, but it wasn't released until 1970. And actually, they were on the road in the tour bus and they saw a dead bird on the side of the road, in the sun. And it turned out to be a buzzard. So they opened to write a tune about jazz guys are weird, man. We're all weird, man. So they wrote a tune called Fried Buzzard. Now, that arrangement was done by John Fetchick. If you don't know who John Fetchick is, he was a trombone player and chief arranger, chief trombone soloist for the Woody Herman Big Band. Now, when you say Woody Herman, you think probably Woodchopper's Ball and Caledonia and, from the dance band era. But Woody kind of went through a change after, the Mount Lewis Big Band really started going, the Buddy Rich Big Band later, and he moved away from the dance band medium and actually moved closer into the let's sit and listen, power big band. That's like some big band red meat, right? So he moved into that direction, hired a lot of top musicians. As a matter of fact, he had two of the Premier League trumpet players on the album. This tune comes right off the album, the 50th anniversary tour. So if you like jazz, if you like big band, and you haven't heard that album, please tonight, go home tonight and look up Woody Herman's 50th anniversary tour. Every single cut on that record is awesome. It's actually one of the four albums that really shaped my taste in music when I was very young. So that came out in 1990. So Woody Herman's been around a long time. Of course, we had the obligatory Woody Herman clarinet solo, right? And there, Ben Swihart, yeah. So we'll hear more from him a little bit later on, yeah. So before we continue, man, let's hear it again for Jazz 2 and Jazz 3, right, man? Let's go. I'll tell you, one of the things, and I'm going to try to do a lot of talking at the beginning, so I'm not doing it at the end. One of the things you'll notice, I think we're going to be able to play all nine tunes tonight. I wasn't sure, man, I talked to the band because, here's the thing, it's kind of been kind of tradition to make sure that, like, seniors all get a chance to solo if they want to. I don't make anyone solo if they don't want to, right? But they all wanted to, and I'm like, well, guys, this is like a professional big band set right here. I mean, your high school kids, you're good, but your high school kids, and you go to the balcony and you listen to the balcony big band, this is like a set that you hear them play, right? It's hard stuff, so we'll see how they're feeling, but I think we're going to be okay. We're going to continue with another Chick Corea tune. Jazz 2 did a Chick Corea tune called Early Afternoon Blues. This one's arranged by the professor of jazz studies and good friend of mine, Mike Tamaro, over at Duquesne University. And this is going to feature our wonderful all-world piano player, Gubby Guts, on piano. This is Windows.
Half one.
That's a cool tune, right? If you noticed, if you're a musician, it wasn't in four. A jazz man played something not in 4/4. Wow, it was in 3/4, right? So that's a tough tune, man. And that's one of the things we decided as a band, and well, as a me. I said, look, guys, I know we've been through a lot. You know, I wanted to say it, the C word, right? We got shut down for a little while. I said, you know, we got two choices here. We can go like we've been going before the pandemic happened, like nothing happened. We're gonna keep up the chart. We're gonna keep up the professional charts. We're gonna keep doing it. Or we can play a couple grade levels down and be comfortable. Every single one, I'm like, no, we wanna go. We wanna go. We want it like it was before. And I'm like, okay, well, you gotta put in the work. And they did. I will tell you, I've had a lot of great big bands. This is the hardest working big band I think I've ever had. Sometimes we get caught up in the moment, you know, and it's like, okay, we got a concert, we got to do this, we got to do this, we got to do this. You just kind of step back and think, these are high school kids, and every single one of these charts, except for maybe one or two, are like professional big band charts. Like that Woody Herman chart here is right from, that's the same notes the Woody Herman band played. It's not dumbed down at all. Same with that Windows chart. So I'm really proud of this group, tremendously proud of this group. I tell you what, let's do this first. Let's introduce part of the band. That's become a tradition as well. And after that performance, I think it's only right to introduce, I think, the most important section of the band, because I'm a drummer. The rhythm section, right? You can't live without a rhythm section. So we're gonna start with our senior piano player, Gubby Guts. He's going to Florida State. I gotta put my goggles on here for a second, right? And our wonderful, wonderful, wonderful bass player, who's also a senior, Madeline White Wolf. Madeline, are you going to school again? Where? Ohio Northern University. Maddie White Wolf on the board. And probably one of the most unsung heroes in a big band is the guitar player, right? If you watch Braden up here, Jake, see that poor kid, right? But he's holding it all together, man, I'm telling you. Like, if you listen to the Count Basie big band, you hear that guitar, that rhythm guitar, that's Freddie Green, right? Jake, he's one of the only people to never be fired from the Count Basie big band. For real. He just keeps that chunk going, keep that thing swinging. So our senior guitar, Braden Lemon. Braden, what are you doing? He's going to the Pennsylvania State University. And last but not least, the most important person on the face of the planet. You could not live life without these humanoids. I'm convinced of it. Our wonderful drummer, who is also a senior, going to Point Park, is that correct? Mr. Zach Musi on the drum. Going to hand out three awards tonight. We handed out a bunch on April 24th, if you were there at the band concert, to seniors. And these awards go to, there's certain criteria they meet. We used to hand them all out at the band concert, but we figured let's do the band ones at the band concert, let's do the marching ones at the band picnic thing, and let's do the jazz ones at the jazz night, right? That way we're not holding it up too much. But it gives me great pleasure to award the Instrumentalist Director's Award for Jazz Band. Now, this means that this person, you know, helps out tremendously. This person actually played in two of the three bands tonight, is a member of the marching band, and really is the steady timekeeper of the group. The Director's Award for the Jazz Ensemble goes to our bass player, Madeline White Wolf. Here for all the seniors up here, because they all deserve an award. We're going to continue with a tune sort of in the vein of Miles Davis, and I think Miles Davis probably played it, entitled Bye Bye Blackbird. That's next, right? Yeah, okay. We're playing so many tunes, I don't know. And this features a student that I've really never heard solo. And he's like, when he's like, I want a solo, I'm like, yeah, man, let's do it. And we listened to a few things, and he's like, yeah, I like that. I like that a lot. So it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you Alex McBriar, and he's going to play Bye Bye Blackbird. Trumpet. How about that? The horn of you, right? trying to say before, you know, if we're playing, hopefully we'll get through 19. So how are you guys feeling so far through 3, okay? Trumpets don't look so good. If you see him doing this, you know we're in a little bit of trouble, okay? But one of the things that, you tell me which tune I'm going to cut, right? Who am I going to say, I'm sorry, the concert's too long, you can't play your song tonight, right? I can't do that. There's no way. There's too many great artists up here, right? So enjoy it, right? These are kids. These are high school kids, man. I forget that sometimes. So this is a great time, after we heard from Mr. McBriar, to introduce the trumpet section. So I'm going to start with our two juniors, both of which I think are looking to continue their careers at North Allegheny Senior High School next year. I think they've signed on. Okay. We have Andrew Warner, who's splitting the lead book. Andrew, say hi. Andrew Warner. And one of the anchors of the trumpet section, making sure they're in tune and holding down all the tonalities and harmonies. Sawyer Wright. And you just heard, of course, senior Alex, where are you going? Boston University, all right, he's going to Boston. Just don't become a Patriots fan, okay, please. No Bruins either. Red Sox I can deal with, okay. Sorry, B. Alex McBriar on the trumpet, he did a great job. And the other person splitting the lead book, a guy I'm kind of familiar with. Where are you going to school again? My son, Tyler Steffen, going to Michigan State University. And finally, our primary soloist back there, and he does such a fabulous job, and he's done a fabulous job all year. And I neglected to mention something in that first tune. You remember the first tune, Fried Buzzard? There was a sax solo, right, where all the saxes were playing. That's typical in a big band chart. What's not typical is a trumpet player sort of playing that with the saxophone section. Now, you know sax parts. So Austin's back there playing all that stuff with the sax section, man. And it provides a great, like, harmony and color to that sax solo. So he did a great job on that. You're going to hear from him here in a little bit as well. So going to another Big Ten school. Going to miss this guy next year. Senior Austin Evango. Austin. All right, we're gonna spice things up here a little bit. Which school? I said Indiana. Didn't I? Oh, Indiana University. I'm sorry, Indiana. Yeah, Indiana Bloomington, right? So, cool, Indiana Bloomington, yeah. And you're gonna hear from Austin a little bit later. Thank you, Governor. Appreciate that. Okay, we're gonna take a chance on this next tune, if you don't mind. Hopefully it'll be okay. It's a Mayor Ferguson tune. And like I said, we wanted to let all the students kind of choose within reason what they wanted to play. And my son Tyler, who said, "Oh, I want to do a Maynard tune." I'm like, "Tyler, why?" Okay, he's like, "Because I like this song." I'm like, "Okay." And what makes my heart warm here too is it not only features Tyler, but it also features Declan Catlos on the trombone and Braden Lemon on the guitar, and these three guys have been friends for a long time. They live at my house sometimes, right? And so it's really cool to, Reed, I see you out there. Reed Moskowitz too, he's sitting right there, right? But it really warms my heart to see all three of these guys soloing on this tune. So cross your fingers for us, but not both, because that's bad luck. Okay, we're gonna attempt to play Maynard Ferguson's Fire Shaker. Thank you. professional busy. This is the last concert we're going to play together. Yeah. Thank God. No. So that was Fire Shaker by Maynard Ferguson. Maynard Ferguson. So what better time than now to introduce the trombone section, right? Huh? But we'll do it anyway. Okay. We'll start with our two juniors, right? Playing lead trombone for us tonight, Mr. Evan Greenberg. Lead trombone. And much like Sawyer does in the trumpet section, holding down our intonation and our harmonies and being really solid on our parts, Ruby Morris. Ruby. And playing the famous last chair trombone. That's funny. He's just like, I play last chair trombone. But really, he's kind of like the tuba of the jazz ensemble, playing bass trombone, man. Love this kid. Playing bass trombone, Declan Catlose. Headed to Belmont University, right? Belmont? Is that correct? Belmont University. And our soloist, in the second chair, and our soloist, you heard her in playing Fried Buzzard, and you're gonna hear her a little bit later on. What a fabulous musician. She is playing second trombone senior and going to Oberlin, Olivia Taranjo. And I did it right. All right, I'm gonna give out one more. We have two more awards to hand out, but I'm gonna give out another one. This is also sponsored by the Instrumentalist magazine. It's called the Woody Herman Award. You know, Woody Herman was a fabulous band leader, clarinet player, for a long time. I sort of gave you the history of the whole band there in a nutshell at the beginning. This goes to an outstanding jazz musician, and he's been with me for all 4 years, I believe. And I'm gonna miss this guy so much. What a great musician. So the Woody Herman Award for Jazz goes to Gubby Gubbs. Entitled Take the A Train. And this is actually the original Take the A Train, as played by the Duke Ellington Orchestra. So the band wants me to do a little Duke Ellington impersonation. So hopefully you'll check that out. And this is gonna feature, like I already introduced him, but man, what a wonderful trumpet player. He's gonna do the Cootie Williams / Ray Nance on trumpet solo in Duke Ellington's Take the A Train. Here we go. Thank you. That was my Duke Ellington impersonation. Did you like it? I'll do another one. I'll do another one later then. Okay. Okay, we're gonna slow things way down with one of my favorite old ballads because it was on one of my favorite records, the Frank Sinatra at the Sands with the Count Basie Orchestra. This is entitled I've Got a Crush on You, and it's gonna be played by Olivia on the trombone. And Olivia, you gonna stand up there or are you gonna come up front? You wanna stand right beside standing? Yeah, your mic's right there, okay. I first learned of this tune actually when I was in 10th grade. And my best friend, still my best friend, my brother, Bob Matchett, played this in high school. And I've loved it ever since, and I've played it a few times, and Olivia's gonna do a terrific job on this. This is I've Got a Crush on You.
Thank you.
for Olivia Toronto on the trombone. I say this every year, man, but these seniors, I'm gonna miss them. So I know we're gonna get back into that. We don't rebuild, we reload mode, but I'm gonna miss a lot of these guys for sure, absolutely. So let's introduce the sax section, right? That's the only section I haven't introduced. It's the least important section of the band. As a matter of fact, it's so not important. Stan Kenton replaced them with mellophoniums at one time, who's a brass instrument. I'm joking, of course. What a fabulous sax section this is. Give that whole sax section. And here's where I got lucky. Here's where I got lucky, right? So on lead alto, he's only a junior, and I believe his future plans for next year are to remain at North Allegheny Senior High School. Andrew Long. And it gets like this where I got lucky. Also a junior. Committed to North Allegheny Senior High School. He committed on May 1st. National signing day, right? He signed with NA. Han Sung Oh. See, I got lucky with the saxophone. Also a junior, playing lead tenor for us, also committing to North Allegheny for next year, Mr. Dan Longo. Yeah. Our band Dan. Playing second tenor for us, another fabulous musician. I have some cool things in store for them next year. Also attending North Allegheny. Is that bit getting old? I'm sorry. Okay. Mr. Ryan Cordero. And where I didn't get so lucky, he's a senior. I'm looking at you. I love this kid so much, man. He's been with me since ninth grade, and I'm hoping I taught him half as much as he's taught me. He's made me a better teacher, a better musician, and I really appreciate him. Mr. Ben Swihart. Hey, we're close to the finish line here. You guys think you're gonna make it? All right. Okay. Oh, well, that's right. Yeah. I keep forgetting. You're going to Penn State. Yeah, Ben's going to Penn State. I'm sorry. I need you guys. I need you guys. Where's it going? All right. We're gonna continue. We're gonna feature someone that never, ever, ever, ever gets featured. But they do like, I mean, without them, we can't. It's like the quarterback of the jazz band. Like, no doubt, it's the quarterback. It's the bass player, right? If you don't notice her, she's doing her job, man. But if she, like, left, you'd be like, dude, what's wrong with the band? It doesn't sound good, right? Yeah, so we're going to feature Madeline Whitewolf on the bass. And she's going to play a Thad Jones composition entitled, This Bass Was Made for Walking. Also going to feature our two tenor players, Ryan and Dan. This is Maddie Whitewolf on the Thad Jones. This bass is made for walking.
One.
All right, we're going to hand out our last award before we play our second to last tune. This is the Louis Armstrong Award for Jazz Ensemble. Of course, goes to an outstanding jazz musician. And we have, as you can tell, we have many of those up here, right? So it makes it really difficult. But this is another one, like I've said before, he's been with me for 4 years. And man, what a great player he is. I hope he doesn't forget me when he becomes rich and famous, makes lots of money, makes records. So, the Louis Armstrong Award goes to Ben Swihart. Okay, I gotta get to do, this is another Duke Ellington favorite. Off one of the same recordings that we did the Take the A-Train, actually. And obviously it's gonna feature Ben Swihart, as done by, I don't know if you've ever heard the recording, but Harry Carney was the Barry saxophone player with the Duke Ellington big band. And this was his staple tune that he always did. And what I like about this is Ben's gonna put a little bit of his own twist on it, which I think is kind of cool. I just have to make sure I don't take it too fast, right? Okay. He said he'd give me a dirty look if I do, so. So I gotta introduce this like Duke Ellington, right? So now, All-American number one baritone sax, Ben Swihart is our next soloist. And Sophisticated Lady, yeah, Ben Swihart.
Thank you.
shape for Ben Swire to get in. Very close. Okay, so we made it to the end. This is our last tune, right? You're probably happy about that. But let's, man, I want to remind you something. These are high school kids. These are high school kids. They just played a professional big band somewhere. Give it to them. I couldn't be more proud. I couldn't be more proud of this group. Looking forward to next year, but I'm going to enjoy this one for a while, okay? All right, we're going to finish things off. I think I gave all the awards, I did all the thank yous, right? We're going to finish things off with a tune that's now associated with a movie entitled Whiplash. I don't recommend you watch it. It was very similar to my college experience in jazz band. Oh, it was. It wasn't that bad, but it was pretty close. I love this Tony Leonardi, but man, I can't repeat some of the things that he said to me. He was always on the drummer, the lead trumpet player, and the bass player. Man, that was like his three favorite people to just rail. But what you should know is Whiplash was actually, I think, written in the 70s, if I'm not mistaken. Am I right about that? Our jazz aficionados, is it the late 60s, 70s? Okay. By Don Ellis, right? And Don Ellis did some weird stuff, man. Like, he had cellos and violins and French horns and all kind of stuff in his jazz band. Not that those instruments are weird, but like for a jazz ensemble, it's kind of a weird kind of thing, you know? But then later it was rearranged for a more standard big band, which is what you're gonna hear right now. So I didn't yell at the band. I didn't ask if they were rushing or they were dragging. I didn't tell them to take my bleeping tempo. Yeah. I didn't do any of that. I didn't throw any chairs. I didn't, you know. I know, it was boring. This is gonna feature Gubby Guts again on the piano. And a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful drum solo by our fabulous drummer, Mr. Zach Musey. This is it for us. We hope you enjoy Whiplash. Ensemble One. Have a great